favorite cinema hall?
Has to be Chaya Cinema.
Yeah, no exclamation, no explanations, just Chaya
Cinema. I regret telling this story.
Hey guys, this is Kitz, and today I have with me Euphoria, who's a CSGO streamer. Pretty sure many of you know him. So Euphoria, please introduce yourself.
So this is me, Adarsh. Like, my real name is Adarsh Singh, and I go with the in-game nick of Euphoria. So I've been playing CS from 10 years or something. So this is pretty much it. And I'm managing the Valorant squad for Velocity Gaming right now. So yeah, this is pretty much it.
You've started streaming since lockdown probably. So tell us about your YouTube journey so far.
So I have been playing CS from a very long time. I used to spend 4-5 hours every day playing CS, but then initially I was pushed to stream by Aman and Silaj. So I started streaming because of them, you can say, because they wanted me to stream. They told me that, you know, since you're spending so much time playing alone, why don't you just turn on the stream and play, and you know, you can interact with a few people while you're streaming. I didn't really have any clue that this thing will be so addicting after a few months. Initially, I had no one watching me. Like, there were 2 viewers, 3 viewers, but then, you know, I slowly got a lot of support from the community, from everyone. People used to share my stream. I had days when, you know, I was streaming till 5 a.m. and I wasn't even playing. There were 4 or 5 people who were just chatting with me. They were just talking about, they wanted to know me. So, you know, I really liked that interaction. And over the time, I took this thing a bit seriously. I thought, you know, since I'm getting so much support from them, I should give them the quality content the people deserve and what they love about me the most. That is, like, a lot of people stopped streaming CS, you can say, lately. So I didn't really want CS to die, right? And I took it as a challenge that I'll become a global elite on stream and something like that, you know. And if people think that, you know, there are only hackers you have to face when you're doing your rank push and things like that, but then this is not the truth. Me and my friend Chirag, we broke all the myths and all the things, you know. It's all inside you, it's totally on you, the people who support you, and it's your will that can make, like, it will help you do a lot of things, achieve a lot of things. Yeah, but the journey was amazing. Like, I will recommend a lot of people, like a lot of people, I'll recommend every one of you who wants to stream, go ahead, start streaming. Don't think a lot about it. Just do what you want to do, and to be precise, do what you enjoy to do. Yeah, that's what I learned from these two.
Now you will see others casting tournaments, then others doing production. I remember 2 years ago, I told others to cast a tournament. Would you like to say what happened, or should I?
I'll tell about it. I'll be frank about it. So I remember doing a LAN event with Silaj. So he told me that, you know, you have to do the servers and everything. So I was like, fine, yeah, I can do that because I have the technical knowledge. Then he says that, will you cast this semi-final or final?
It was the final.
And I was like, will you cast the finals? I was like, what do I do? Like, hey, look, there's a player rushing with a smoke in his hand. Is he gonna throw this? Oh, he smoked day long. And I had literally nothing to, you know, I had nothing to frame the whole scenario. Like, I used to choke. I simply used to choke while doing these things. But then, now I think I can do it.
Now you're confident enough. I remember it was like 5 minutes. Others tried. Then he's like,
5 minutes. I was done.
I need food.
Silaj got me food, so basically this was my escape. So we were supposed to have our lunch, and he told me, hey, your food is there, okay, you can have it when you're done. And the moment I started casting, within 5 minutes I was like, I'm done,
I'm very hungry, I have to eat.
I'm very hungry, I cannot cast. I was giving lame excuses, and I was like, okay.
What do you think about the CS scene in India?
The CS scene has two perspectives, I would say. As a streamer, the viewership is there. It's just a matter of fact that you need to get recognized. People are not even aware of the pros. Like, there are people who watch my streams, and there's a thing I do which I have named as Inside Esports India. So I've covered most of the professional players who Everyone should know, like Antidote, when he didn't retire. Before he retired, I had him on my stream. I had Deathmaker, I had Hellfighter, I had Hellranger. I still remember at least 15 to 20 people asking, who is Deathmaker, who is Antidote? And I was like, dude, you love CS, you watch CS, but then the awareness of the game is still not there. Like the professional scene, right? So if you're not aware of the professional scene, you don't know what is going across the competitive scene, the scene won't grow. It's the viewership that helps any game grow, right? Like, why did PUBG Mobile grow more? Because it had more accessibility, more people knew about it. Like, our parents know about PUBG, but they don't know about CS.
Yeah.
Why? So this answers pretty much it. So as a streamer, I've seen CS players not having the enough knowledge. So there should be awareness across, right? Mm-hmm. The very reason I started this Inside Esports India thing. Now the people who got associated me, they know how the professional scene works. And talking about the professional scene in specific as player's perspective, because I kind of played at semi-pro level, I attended a lot of LAN events and everything. Like, I had a lot of experience, right? I'll share them slowly, but then as organizers and brands, they are not getting
the apartment
participants in the viewers to continue this thing.
So you,
need to do something about it.
What do you think about Valorant?
So as Valorant was introduced, right, when the global release was done, I didn't have a lot of subscribers back then. I had around 1000 subscribers or something, and that first stream after the Valorant's global release, it ended up having around 2000 views or something like that. So I got a first hand experience of the game even during the beta days. Initially I really thought the game is gonna be a blast. Yes, it was. It's definitely it's definitely a huge success in terms of gaining audience, in terms of catching the attention of the players and everyone, right? A lot of CSGO players have shifted to Valorant as well. So the Valorant scene, according to me, it's gonna go huge because it has got a massive push due to a lot of reasons. A, because of Riot themselves, if I'm not wrong, because unlike I won't exactly say CS, like Valve takes care of their games, but then Riot specifically, if I say, they are way too harsh when
they
it
know
comes
how
to hackers and cheaters.
Yeah,
they know how to handle the community, right? So if you are a hacker, if you are caught hacking, bro, you need to change your PC.
Yeah.
You need a new life. You need a complete new start, a complete new PC to begin that game again, yeah, with a new ID. Unlike CS, if you hack, you just can buy the game for free, or you can just buy a old account for $500, as near as that. It's so cheap. So according to those terms, it won't make people that frustrated when it comes to the player's perspective and talking about the competitive scene, right? A lot of players have changed, not changed, they've completely shifted to Valorant right now because they see more hopes in this game. It's definitely there, unlike CS, which was totally skill-based, Valorant needs a lot of brains, definitely. Like, you can do so much with this game. There are around 10, I think, if I'm not wrong.
More than 10.
How many agents are there? More than 10, if I'm not wrong. So there are so many agents, right? You can play as a duelist if you're an aggressive player. You can use a controller. If you're a supporter, you can use a sentinel. There are initiators. There are so much. So there are a lot of things. So this scene is growing right now. Like, I don't even have to say, there are so many tournaments going around. Within last 3 months, I've seen at least 30-40 lakhs coming up from sponsors and brands in this particular game just in India. And
plus, the viewership is really high for Valorant.
Insane.
I have never seen any PC game getting in that much viewership in India.
The mobile community specifically, I'll say, these guys have given a huge boost to Valorant. Yeah, huge boost. So the PC community is getting very nice support. So yeah, Valorant will do wonders. And we won India today, 2 days back. So the winner of India today got a chance, has got a slot for the PvP finals, the regionals or something like that in Singapore. So See, we already have got the opportunity to represent India internationally, and the prize pool is massive. The smallest tournament they do has the prize pool of $5,000.
Nice talking to you, others. So this is time for the rapid fire round. I'll ask you 10 questions.
Okay.
And you just have to say yes, no, or just answer whatever you feel like. No explanation. You just answer. And it is not about any cinema. It is not about any cinema hall. Don't worry.
Okay. Backstory, guys.
Yeah. We don't talk about that.
Yeah, we don't talk about it yet.
We don't talk about it.
Not yet.
Anyway, so what do you prefer, playing solo or with squad?
Solo.
You're playing solo. CSGO or Valorant?
Yeah. CSGO.
Your favorite battle royale game?
Call of Duty Warzone. Any day, hands on.
Playing for esports team or managing it?
Managing it.
Which Valorant agent do you hate the most?
Has to be Cypher if I'm playing against it.
Your favorite Indian CSGO player?
Has to be right to us. There are two. I'll give you two names, or I'll give you three names. Because there are a lot of different things these players do right as their role. So it has to be right to us, Deathmaker, and Antidote. Three of them.
Okay. Favorite Indian Valorant streamer?
Favorite Indian Valorant streamer?
Streamer, yes.
Okay. I really enjoy Right to Ace stream. He's so informative. You know, he plays so well.
Right? It's so fun, yes.
Yeah, and it's so much fun. And it's like it's visible on in each and every game he plays, that the brains he's putting in.
Yes, right, exactly.
So it's really, really interesting to watch him play. I love him.
Have you ever slapped anyone in the face?
Oh, yes. Very hard. Very hard.
What's the first PC game you have ever played?
What's the?
First PC game you played.
Return of the Castle Wolfenstein.
Ooh. You have improved a lot in last 6 months.
Thanks for being there.
It's so nice to see him doing all this. Like, I know him since 2018, probably 18 or 19.
Yeah.
I saw him playing in LAN tournaments. I saw him, like, he helped me in LAN tournaments. From that to him failing on casting a final match, then him started streaming. Now he is casting big tournaments in India. It's amazing. It's amazing to see others doing all this, to be honest. It's amazing. Anyway, so that's it for today's episode, guys. Anything you want to say to your fans, Adarsh?
Keep supporting the community, guys. You know, no matter what, if you like, and you know, guys, if you have anything about someone, just speak it out. If you're joining anyone's stream, just drop a hi, because, you know, you have no idea how much it motivates any streamer to, you know, have a little bit of support from a random person's end. So, you know, I do that quite a lot. I just join random people's stream. I drop them a hi. There's a smile that comes in their face, you know, that's definitely going to make your day as well. So keep supporting the community, and, you know, we'll definitely have India at a very nice position when it comes to esports. And probably people can proudly say that, you know, I'm going in esports, and they won't have to explain what esports is.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But you never join my stream or say hi. You just talk.
Hey.
You don't say hi.
Yeah, because, you know, I like your stream is always there in my background. I say a goodbye before it ends, or I even join you when you're playing whenever it's possible.
Yeah, I know. Just my friend. Anyway, so that's it, guys. That's Euphoria for you guys. I'll leave his channel link in the description. Do subscribe, do follow him. If you're a CSGO fan, you should definitely watch his games. And yeah, he did a grind to global elite in matchmaking. Like, dude, hats off. Anyway, so that's it. This is me, Kitz, signing off from today's episode. See you guys in the next one. Bye-bye. Bye.